Beat
103.
Hi Sarah, how are you doing?
I'm fine, thanks JD, how are you?
Yes, I'm very well, thank you. Thank you for returning for another travel show.
You are more than welcome.
Thank you. Now, holidays are now looking more possible. Are staycations more popular than ever this year?
Definitely. In all the bookings that I've done, and it's definitely got busier because there are now bookings coming back in, I would say it's 70, maybe even 80% are UK, and there may be 20% abroad. It's probably even more than 80% UK. I think people are just generally not so much afraid, maybe, but because it's so obviously still raw, the situation, they're just thinking, I want to stay in the UK for safety's sake. So yes, they are definitely more popular this year.
Brilliant. And today we're going to talk about Jersey. I've been to Jersey. It is amazing. Tell us what there is to do there.
Of course. Well, Jersey is basically a home away from home. So it does offer you the opportunity to reconnect with yourself and loved ones while making some amazing memories. I mean, the beaches themselves are absolutely stunning. Now, the island, a lot of people don't realise this, is only 9 miles by 5. So it's not exactly big, but it is the biggest of the Channel Islands. Obviously, you're only a little way away from the UK mainland, but it's somewhat different and it's even slightly exotic as well. So you will feel you are a little bit further away than what you actually are. It's less than an hour flight away from London, and many of the UK's regional airports now, obviously, you don't have to fly. If you would rather not board the plane and prefer to indulge in slow travel, you can hop on the Condor ferries. They depart from Jersey, from Poole or Portsmouth, so you get a couple of choices. And the government of Jersey has introduced a safer travel policy because of COVID-19, designed to help travellers stay safe on their island break. So there's lots of things to do, and we can just go through a few of them now for you. So whether it's a pick of miles of hidden beaches and bays to hire a bicycle, you've also got the new EV electric bike routes. They're perfect for those who just want to explore the island in a leisurely way while seeing all that fantastic scenery. As I said, you've got the secluded beaches, you've got the bays, you've got the coves. You can go with a Jersey forager on a food safari in Groveville Bay. So where the Seymour oyster beds, you can learn how the shellfish are cultivated. The La Mer Estate, the food curious can taste the local wine, chocolate and the island's black butter delicacy. Doesn't look very nice, but I've been told it tastes absolutely divine. And if you like to try new spirits, you might even want to stop by the distillery for a gin or a rum tasting. And you wouldn't think all this was possible on one little island. And of course, your main thing for Jersey, or one of the bigger attractions, especially for families, is the Jersey Zoo, known as the Jewel in the Crown. It's all conservation themed, an animal haven, so you've got some of the world's most exotic and beautiful creatures. So there's lemurs, bears, gorillas, orangutans, flamingos. It also has a breeding program for wildlife released back into the wild, and it's all about educating the young that visit. So it really is just a fantastic island, and there's plenty more as well.
Have you got any offers for us today?
I have. So they're all with Hoseasons, and because we are talking about UK, or in Jersey, but still UK, they're all UK breaks. So April for UK, I think it's from about the beginning of April, you can start to stay overnight for, you know, locally. That starts from £88. These ones I've got, the main ones, are all August, just to make sure we are perfectly fine by the time we do get around to that. Stanwix Park in Cumbria, that comes in at around £480 for a week. Angecroft Park, Scottish Borders, £589 for a week. Lido Beach, Prestatyn, that's North Wales, £599 for a week. Brixham Holiday Park, which I've been to when I was younger, and it's brilliant there, £624 for a week, that's in Devon. Bognor, £625, Dorset, £675, and there's some others as well. And you've got to remember, with Hoseasons, that's not per person. So if that's based on a unit sleeping six, for example, then that price will be for six people. So it works out exceptionally value for money.
Brilliant. So people can find all this information out on the guide. How can people find that?
Yeah, of course. So go on to our station here at Beat. So beatradio103.co.uk and just go to the Beat 103 travel guide and you'll find links there to all my pages, including the travel show one, where you'll find the full 5-page guide that gives you lots more information about Jersey and the hashtags for all their social media, plus all these offers as well.
Thank you very much, Sarah. We'll be back with you next week.
You will. Thank you, JD. Have a lovely weekend.
Beat 103. 103. 103. 103.